Hello there and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry and I created this video to help you avoid phishing emails and other scams that are appearing in our email boxes and on our phone's messenger services more and more. New phishing scams are being developed all of the time. And without staying on top of these new techniques, you could unwittingly fall prey to one of them. And before I forget, please click on that thumbs up icon as that really helps the channel. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel. So now let's look at some of the ways to avoid becoming a victim. Point number one, think before you click. Sure, it's okay to click on links when you know that you're at a trusted website, but how do you know that you're at a real site and not just some copycat website aimed at stealing your login credentials? First, look at the top there at your URL address box. At the very beginning of it, it should have a closed lock symbol as seen here. Next, notice the URL address's domain name. An incorrect domain name can lead you anywhere from an erroneous website to a phishing scam. For example, let's look at Wells Fargo's URL address as seen here. Notice how it starts at HTTPS. That's the secure version of HTTP, and that's a good start. Next, we see www.wellsfargo.com without any misspellings or strange additions like wellsfargo44.com or wellsfargo.net. Next, don't forget to check if the domain's name ending is correct. Is it .com, .net, .org, or something else? The wrong ending means that the website that loads may very well be a copycat. And if you're not sure, you can always run Google's Transparency Report tool. Now I have a link to that tool down in the description, and all you have to do is copy the suspected URL address and paste it into that tool. It will then run a check and see if everything is okay. And if anything is fishy about that website, it'll let you know ASAP. And next, although it is a common practice for some retailers to provide large price discounts on items to move their inventory or to promote new products or services, if you find a site that offers an unbelievable deal, then think twice before continuing. If it's too good to be true, chances are it's probably not legit. And my next point is never share personal information. As a general rule, you should never share personal or financial information over the internet. Now, this rule applies to phone calls, emails, and websites. Now, if you do need to share, then go and visit the main website of that company in question and get their phone number and give them a call. Most of the phishing emails will actually direct you to web pages which masquerade as legitimate web pages or legitimate financial institutions where entries of your financial or personal information are required. You should never make confidential entries through the links provided in these emails. And never send an email with sensitive information. And make it a habit to always check the URL address found at the top of your browser screen there. A secure website should always start with HTTPS or have the lock symbol at the very beginning. And for the next point, be generally reluctant to download email attachments. Before downloading that attachment, check the source. Is it from someone you know? You can always just go and call that individual and ask them, hey, did you send me a certain email with a certain attachment? And if you do download it, you should scan it with your antivirus app. An easy way to do that is to place your cursor on the attachment and then right-click with the mouse. You will be given several options, including one to scan it with the antivirus program. Left-click while the cursor is touching or highlighting that option, and your antivirus program will scan it and give you the results. And point number four is to install an anti-phishing toolbar. Now, most internet browsers allow you to customize them with an anti-phishing toolbar. Such toolbars run quick checks on sites that you are visiting and compare them to a list of known phishing websites. So if you happen to stumble upon a malicious website, the toolbar will alert you right away. This is just one more layer of protection against phishing scams. And the best part is that these toolbars are completely free. One free anti-phishing toolbar that I actually use is Bitdefender's Traffic Light. The security layer from this extension does a very good job of protecting you from unknown, nefarious, dark actors on the web. So the gateway is better protected. It is also very useful in telling you what information of yours a website could potentially track, as well as outright blocking malicious websites. Now I have a link to the Bitdefender's Traffic Light down in the description. And number 5 is, don't fall for the "is this you" in this video scam. Now I made a whole video about this scam and how to avoid it, and it's above me up there. But whenever you get a message or an email asking you, "is this you" in this video, do not click the link, as it leads to a fake login site that looks very similar to a real social media site or even a real YouTube site, but it never opens a video. All it does is it steals your credentials as you type them in. So again, never click on those links that say, "is this you" in this video. Number 6 is turn on two-step verification for your Google account. Now to do that, go ahead and open up the browser for Google there, and then go to google.com, as you see I've done there. And once you're there, you should see your avatar. Now, if you don't see your avatar, that means you haven't logged in, so make sure you do log in. And above me, you see the avatar there. Go ahead and click it, and then click on Manage Your Google Account. From there, you get into your settings, and what you need to do is click on Security. And then you'll scroll down through this screen a little bit. There's a lot of security information there, by the way. But one important thing there, it says two-step verification. You notice on mine, it's off. So to turn it on, just click on on, and you're greeted with this screen. It basically tells you about two-step verification. And what it is basically whenever you log into your Google account from another location or from another device, Google will send you a one-time use PIN or code number on your cell phone, so that you need to enter in that number into the device there to actually access your account. And to get started, all you gotta do is click on the blue button that says Get Started. Now once you've done that, make sure you do have your cell phone with you, as Google will send you a message to make sure that you are linking the correct phone number with your account. And number 7 is check your online accounts regularly. If you haven't logged into your online accounts for a while, then someone else may be having a field day with them. So even if you don't technically need to log into your online accounts, check in with each of those on a regular basis and get into the habit of updating or changing the password every 6 months or sooner. And to catch bank phishing or credit card phishing scams, you should also inspect your statements very carefully. If you don't already do, get monthly statements for your financial accounts and check each of the entries for any fraudulent activity. And for number 8, we have be cautious of pop-ups. Pop-up windows often disguise themselves as legitimate components for a particular website, but all too often they are actually phishing attempts. Most popular browsers allow you to block pop-ups, and you can allow them on a case-by-case basis. Now, if one does slip through the cracks, don't click on the cancel button, but click on the small X found in the upper corner of that window. Or you can use the keyboard shortcut, Control W, and that works with Chromebooks, Windows PCs, as well as Macs. I use AdBlock Plus, which is a free extension that actually does a very good job of blocking these pop-up windows. And I have a link to that one down in the description. Now, some may not actually like AdBlock Plus because if you read a lot of stuff about it online, some say that it can actually be compromising your privacy. So if you don't want to use AdBlock Plus or any of the other extensions, remember you can always use Control W to close off those pop-up windows. And time for number 9, keep your web browsers up to date. Security patches and updates are available and released for browsers all of the time. And this is in response to hackers and phishers discovering loopholes and then exploiting them. So let me show you how to update your Chrome browser. So if you notice the three dots above me there, go ahead and click on those and then go down to settings. Once you click on settings, the settings window will open and notice at the bottom there, it says about Chrome. Go ahead and click that. And right there in the middle, you have the ability to update Chrome. Now right now it says that currently it's up to date, but if yours was not up to date, it would actually be updating right now and be installing that for you. Number 10 is use firewalls. High quality firewalls act as a buffer between your computer and the outside world where intruders and hackers try to get through. Firewall protection prevents access of malicious files by blocking the attacks from even starting. You should use two different types of firewalls, a desktop firewall and a network firewall. The desktop firewall is a type of software and is automatically turned on in Windows, Chrome OS, and Mac OS. The second firewall type is hardware and is normally part of your network router. You would need to log in to your router's home site and edit any of the firewall settings from there. And that information can be found within your router's manual. When used together, they can drastically reduce the odds of hackers and phishers infiltrating your computer and your network. Next is number 11, antivirus software. The good news is that Windows 10, 11, and Chrome OS all have built-in antivirus software that offer fairly good protection. Windows Defender does a decent job protecting you, but it lacks many features that can be found in other third-party antivirus apps like Avast One Essential or Bitdefender Antivirus Free Edition. If you're using a Chromebook, then it already has one of the best antivirus protections built in. Essentially, a Chromebook can protect you from any virus and from most forms of malware. Just be sure to keep your software up to date as new virus definitions are added all the time because new scams are always being dreamed up. Now for Windows users, anti-spyware and firewall settings should be used to prevent phishing attacks, and users should update their programs regularly. Antivirus software scans every file which comes through the internet to your computer. It helps to prevent damage or loss of data on your system. So there you have it. You don't have to live in fear of phishing scams any longer. By keeping the tips shown in this video, you can enjoy a worry-free online experience. Now I know that there are maybe other tips out there that I haven't covered in the video, and if you know of one or more that have been very helpful to you, really appreciate it if you can add it to the comments and share it with others. If you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and I really do appreciate all the comments and everything else that you've shared with me. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.